ko was present nung nag-meeting kami ng October 5. You heard the statement of the representative ng University of St. Louis claiming na may 1 million na usapan galing sa agent na yun yung binabanggit kanina on our executive session, Madam Chair. Pero ang problema, 1 million paparesibo, 200,000 lang ang actual mahulog o may iwan sa eskwelahan. That was USL. Narinig mo yun, RD. No? Narinig mo yun. Nandun ka kasama si RD ng NICA. And of course, ang St. Paul kasi ngayon, hindi nag-attend yung nag-attend sa meeting ko. So, i-manifest ko mamaya yun, Madam Chair. At ang St. Paul, nung sinabi na 1.2 million yung sa St. Paul, he neither denied nor confirmed. But sinasabi niya, at that juncture, Madam Chair, na 4,600 students na nag-enroll since the start ng internalization program ng St. Paul at 1-2 ang existing enrolled noong October 5. So, i-clear ko lang po yun, Madam Chair, at ang target ng St. Paul, yung representative nila noon, na si PJ Lapay, ay target daw ng St. Paul University Philippines is about 10,000 Chinese students. So, iklaro ko po lang yun.
Yes, Madam Chair, the St. Paul representative is here. May we know again whether you have come back to this room after the executive session? Is he here?
Yes, Your Honor.
St. Paul. Okay, so now, we now hear from the horse mouth.
But he's a different guy.
But we'll ask him now because he represents St. Paul. It's already 4,600 in St. Paul, and you intend to have 10,000 students. Can you answer that? You are under oath.
Good afternoon, Madam Chair, and Your Honors. I am Jeremy Godofredo Morales. I'm the Director for Internationalization at St. Paul University, Philippines. Number one, I was not the one who attended the meeting, as our good congressman has been saying. So I also would like to say that I was not verified, or I was not asked before numbers were given out. Currently, the numbers of foreign students at St. Paul University, Philippines. Yes, ma'am.
You did not take your oath yet?
I did, ma'am.
He did already.
I did. Yeah. Thank you.
So what's the direct answer? Did your school receive 1.2 and only this much is receipted?
No,
the
Your
others
Honor.
Went somewhere? Please state your answer.
No, Your Honor. St. Paul University, Philippines does not charge 1.2 million
pesos. How much
pesos.
Is being charged?
The university charges $1,000 per trimester for each foreign student. And the students for tuition fee per trimester, and in 1 year, the students enroll in 4 trimesters. So for the students to complete their graduate school program, they are enrolled in at least 10 trimesters. So if we put together that $1,000 times 10 per trimester times 10 trimesters, that's only $10,000. So it does not reach 1.2 million pesos.
It will reach 580,000 per 80. It's now 58.6. So it's almost a million also. But anyway, that is your answer. And we will go further here. And you are under oath. So, Madam Chair, just to wind up, because we're winding up, I now go to the DFA. You are, as stated by my good commissioner and chairman and minority leader, you are in the forefront of protecting us. How many note verbals have we issued against China for this violation since the president, PBBM, assumed office? How many notes verbal for the intrusion of these Chinese vessels in our sovereign West Philippine Sea?
Thank you, Congressman. I would like to answer that, but I am not in the Office of the Maritime of Ocean Affairs.
That is all over the papers, Director Feliciano.
I know there have been several
hundreds. It's about 350.
Yes.
It's in the papers.
Yes.
Me, even if I'm not in the DFA, I know because I read. Every day, almost, we have about verbal. So, were you not alarmed that, for example, EDCA site, Cagayan, Santa Ana, the naval port, in that part, and then near, proximate to Batanes, which China is trying to claim and to really get. Were you not alarmed that these are just too many in a particular place?
Okay. Thank you, Congressman. So before I answer your question, let me, I want to add something more to the previous. Okay, so aside from the authenticity of the documents, the identity of the applicant, and the purpose of visit, we also, of course, ascertain whether a certain foreign national is a security risk, which is why we conduct security clearances with BI and NICA, and we work closely with them. So yun po yung basis namin to ascertain whether a certain person
you
is...
You didn't find that a large influx of Chinese students will not be a security risk? Huh? You are with the Office of the Consular Affairs. Okay. Huh?
Let me... We have taken note of all of the House resolutions, of all of the POGO activities, sex trafficking, etc., and the influx of Chinese. In fact, our... office and our undersecretary will be conducting an interagency committee meeting on visa concerns tomorrow precisely to address these issues with a view to harmonizing the policies or maybe even revise the policies based on the security concerns that have been raised in the recent months. So we are taking very good notes, sir. Don't
Thank
worry.
You.
And we seek to strengthen our visa policies and make it even stricter, if need be, which is obviously needed.
You're already, the DFA, can you just finish? The DFA secretary already said that there'll be stricter rules, right? Do you confirm that?
Yes,
that
sir.
That the DFA has now issued to all consulars, especially China, to be stricter on issuances to the Chinese students or nationals coming in. Finally, I'll wind up already. Thank you, DFA, Director Feliciano. We go now to immigration. You are in the last leg of all this particular setup, no? When your immigration student desk, when they issue the conversion from 9A to 9F, did you make sure that all the requirements that were required by the DFA and schools, that they were all present when you converted this particular visas?
Thank you, Your Honor. 100% we can assure the committee that the student visa section scrutinize and assess the completeness and authenticity of all the supporting documents. And to add, we only issue student visa conversion if there is a notice of acceptance from the school and that school is authorized to accept foreign students.
And under your helm, there will be no more pastilla scheme because Chairman Abante has stated in his resolution of some corrupt activities of the Bureau of Immigration. Of course, that was not during time. During your time, do you commit that you're going to perform your duties diligently and with integrity? Commissioner Norman Tansingco?
Unqualified commitment, Your Honor.
Unqualified commitment. That is good enough. Congratulations, Commissioner. With that, I end, Madam Chair. And I am going to the meeting with the DPWH because I have many requests for infrastructure. Thank you very much to those who are here. Thank you. Sana all.
Committee, no? Si Chairman Dan Fernandez is already outside. I'm sorry for rushing you.
Madam Chair, pwede ba ako kahit konti?
Lastly, minority si Kong Abante, si Kong Manuel.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Isa lang, kasi nga nabanggit na i-revise yung policies sa conversion ng visa. Gusto lang natin makuha, at least para may definite na panghawakan yung committee. May timeline po ba kailan pwedeng ma-produce yung ganong updated na policy. Kasi policies. Yun nga, given na merong tayong security situation, ayaw natin na maabuso siya, di ba? Yung nako-convert from temporary visa patungo student visa. Can yan we, lang, Madam Chair.
Can we ask the agencies to submit this so that we can distribute to the members? Yes, Kong Abad.
Gusto ko lang itanong, Madam Chair, itong St. Paul, no? Ilan ang current enrollment ngayon sa inyo ng Chinese, ha?
Good afternoon po. Currently, we have 828 Chinese students. And I would just, may I be allowed to clarify? We never reached 4,600 total of Chinese students enrolled in any year of at St. Paul University, Philippines.
But you have 800 right now.
Yes po, sir.
That's so, nagbayad yan ng $10,000 each.
Per trimester din po sila nagbabayad.
Okay.
Hindi po minsan.
Are they still there now?
Many of them are in Tuguegarao.
How many are attending face-to-face classes?
About 200 po.
What are the others doing?
The others, since they came before, since they went home sometime, their visas expired, their student visas expired, so they had to apply for a new tourist visa.
So pag alimbawa nag-expire ang kanilang visa, ano ginagawa ninyo?
We notify them, we notify our students of the policies and procedures and the activities in the university that they need to come already to the university because we're going back to face-to-face. Kapag nag-expire na po yung visa nila, we give them letter of acceptance after verifying that they are still enrolled with the university. After
are you able all, to, Madam Chair, are you able to get all of the requirements properly and officially?
Yes, sir. The red ribbon documents, yes, sir.
You have that?
Yes, sir. In the university, authenticated by the Philippine Embassy.
Pinuntahan na ba kayo ng NICA about that?
Yes, po. There were representatives, po.
Pinuntahan na kayo?
Yes, po, sir.
Okay. Therefore, Madam Chair, I just would like to manifest here that there are not only 400 enrolled in Cagayan. St. Paul, 800 po ang enrolled. And all of them paid $10,000 each. Ang laki ng kita ng St. Paul, ha? Ang laki ng kita ng St. Paul. Therefore, Madam Chair, dadagan pa nila yung malaki ang kita, eh. Oo. And then, the NICA went there. I do not know why they're here today. They are present only, Madam Chair, but they do not even know why they are present. So therefore, in the next meeting we have, Madam Chair, we're going to have another session here, that the NICA people should have their own heads here, including the ESAP, including the National Security Council. And they must be prepared, Madam Chair, to submit to us all the documents needed that they should submit.
So at the next meeting, we will require all the heads of the agencies, and then all the documents should be submitted. And since you were invited, you have to prepare. Hindi pa pwedeng pupunta kayo dito na hindi niyo alam kung bakit kayo nandito. Okay? And lastly, the author, before we adjourn.
Yeah, just a point of clarification before I will seek for a motion to suspend, Madam Chair. I will reiterate my invitation for the resource person of St. Paul University, Philippines, the guy who we had a meeting with the director of CHED back then, PJ Lapay, because he was the one who gave us the figures. Voluntary po yun, hindi po ko tinatanong yun sa kanya galing. So from that end, no, pati yung sa St. Louis University, Madam Chair. Kasi may konting discrepancy na, pero i-reserve ko na sa next hearing. Kasi nasabi ni Chairman kanina, Commissioner, na mukhang 85 o 52 lang na-renew. Ngayon, 800 plus pala ang Commissioner. Narinig mo siguro yung sinabi ng St. Paul, no? 800 plus ang estudyante nila. How come 52 lang ngayon? Saan ang galing na yung dokumento na nila, no?
So the 52 yung honor is extension.
Yeah.
Not conversion, extension.
Okay. So i-verify na lang natin on the next hearing. So with this Madam Chair, I move for the suspension of this. Yeah. Thank you.